dying as little as possible, killing as many opponent characters as you can. In the end, this is the whole point of online first-person shooters, isn't it? So here are some tips on how to stay alive and die less in COD Ghosts. First tip, map knowledge. Map knowledge is extremely important to have. Keeping track of the high traffic routes, choke points, cover and hideouts can give you an amazing advantage. Also, knowing the spawn point of the enemy is crucial. To have a rough idea about where the enemy is spawning, look at your fellow teammates that are on the map. It is almost certain that the enemies won't be spawning over there. Minimap. The minimap can provide useful information on the enemy's whereabouts. Make sure to give it a glance to know the opponent's position. If you know the opponent's position, you can easily pick them off. But do not spend all your time looking at the minimap. It must not take your attention away from the game. Flanking. Storming your opponents face to face is a game of chance. You have usually got a 50-50 chance of success. These aren't exactly good odds in a game where who dies the least wins. How can you get the odds in your favor? Well, here's the way. You see a hostile? Take note of where he or she is situated. Pick another route instead of a full frontal attack. Surprise them with a flank attack or attack them from behind. I'm not saying that you should do this every single time, but keep this technique in mind. Watch your reload, soldier. Don't reload. Here's a classic scene for you. You've just killed an enemy. You hurry to reload, even though your clip is practically full, because someone once told you that you should reload between each kill. Suddenly, that dead dude's buddy shows up. Boom, your character can now be found lifeless on the ground. Why? Well, because you can't cancel the reloading animation to shoot. And the animation usually takes a couple of seconds in which you're vulnerable. These seconds tend to be enough time for the hostile to kill your character. So what do you suggest? Wait to reload. Either till you're safe behind cover, or you're sure that the character you just killed doesn't have mates lurking about. This tip is really about being conscious. Conscious of how many rounds you've got left in your mag after each gunfight. If your clip's more than half full, you will be able to take out at least one more character before the reload becomes necessary. Blueprint deaths. Blueprint deaths work like so. Your character gets shot to death by a hostile. You get pissed off and swear revenge. As soon as you respawn, you move your character back to the place where it died the last time. Bang! Dead. Again. Angrier and keener on revenge, you return once more. This time, you are more careful. Of course. Bang bang. Well, that didn't work either. Your character died again. In the same place, by the gun of the same opponent. Why does this keep happening to you? Well, because you're playing predictably. Your opponents gamble on the fact that you'll do what a lot of players do. Return to the same spot time and time again, chasing for revenge. What should you do instead? Don't use the same route. Find an alternative. Try flanking the damned opponent. Or try attacking from behind. Or perhaps, best of all, let revenge lie for a little while and move in a completely different direction. These were just a few tips on how to increase the duration between each respawn. Hopefully, these tips will help you become an overall better player. This has been Ninja4700. Thank you and goodbye.
SATCOM uplink enabled.